took the tarps off about an hour ago. Our broadcast today is in Spanish. We're available using the SAP button on your television. Rich, playing in these conditions, how difficult is it?
Kevin, I don't care how good a quarterback you are, how big your hands are. The weather is a factor. You know, the quarterback center exchange, the handoffs to the running backs, receivers slipping or hesitant out of breaks, it all has an impact on the performance of the quarterback position. We could see Alex Smith wear gloves. Derek Carr told us on Friday he will not wear gloves. He feels comfortable throwing the ball in the rain.
Chiefs won the toss. They have deferred. The Raiders will receive. Cairo Santos has it teed up on the 35, and away we go in rainy Oakland. Jalen Richard, he'll take it inside the 5. One of the top return men in the NFL with a scheme and a block by Holmes and chased by Barrington, and Santos pushes him out of bounds. It is a return of 50 yards. They'll be at the Chiefs 46 to the sideline in Scott Kaplan.
Kevin, Rich, your miss down here on the field. Guys, the rain continues to come down heavily. And Rich, you were talking about all the different things can be affected by the rain. Take a look at this. These are the difference between 5/8 of an inch and a half inch cleats. Many of these players have decided to go to the spikes, the screw-in spikes, because under perfect field conditions, they would wear molded cleats, but they've got to plant and cut if they're going to be able to stay on their feet for this game, guys.
Scott, thank you. DeAndre Washington in the backfield. It is a first and 10. Carr. And he's got Amari Cooper. Banged out of bounds by Barry. He's near the 30. It is a gain of 11 on the play. As you take a look at Derek Carr, Pro Football Focus, Rich has him as the number 4 quarterback in the NFL.
I think that first play tells you just what they think about the rain. It's not going to affect Derek Carr. Watched him at practice on Friday, Ken. I thought he really handled the ball well, threw it well in the rain. His time clock is extremely fast in the way he plays the game. He processes information so quickly and efficiently at the line of scrimmage.
It's a first and 10. This is the rookie out of Texas Tech, DeAndre Washington. Stacked up Poe and all kinds of Chiefs defenders right there, bringing him down after a gain of 2. He got to the 33-yard line. They've got Austin Howard starting at the right tackle. He's the 5th different starting right tackle. Osemele and Hudson have been terrific, opening holes in the middle toward the left side with Donald Penn, a longtime starter. Here you take a look at Michael Crabtree. He is off to a Pro Bowl start. He has been terrific. He and Amari Cooper are a dynamic 1-2 punch at the receiver. It's Carr with the 2nd down and 8. There was pressure from Ford, and he finds his receiver. That's Cooper again. He's down to the 16-yard line. Johnson was there at the stop, 18-yard pickup after he made a catch for 11 the last time, another first down.
Well, the one thing that really jumps out at you when you study Amari Cooper on tape, he's got excellent burst and acceleration off the line of scrimmage, and he's extremely productive after the catch.
Carr, 1st and 10. Look at the time, but blocked by Penn at the left tackle. And Cooper again. Over there, looked like Gaines grabbing him around the waist. Another 11-yard gain. So Cooper has caught it for 11, for 18, and 11 again. He's been a one-man wrecking crew on this drive.
One of the problems with the field conditions, Kevin, in the rain, is you can't rush the passer. It makes it very difficult for the big men. Makes it difficult for Tamba Hali and Dee Ford to really put their foot in the ground and get to Derek Carr.
1st and goal at the 4. Washington. He's down to about the 3-yard line with a gain of 1 yard on the play. And you can see the pile there for the Chiefs. Zombo and Bailey with the stop.
There's a couple different mindsets if you're a play caller in this type of weather. You think we're going to pack them in, we're going to run the football, we're going to take care of the football, we're not going to turn it over. That's not really the mindset of Bill Musgrave or even Jack Del Rio, because they know they've got a trigger that's comfortable throwing the ball in the rain, and they have a big, massive offensive line that doesn't give up sacks.
Raiders have brought in another tight end. Chiefs have brought in another linebacker. 2nd and goal at the 3. Carr looking for Rivera in the corner. Ford was defending, and he splashes out of bounds. He caught it, but it's out of bounds and incomplete.
And that's the problem for a guy like Rivera if you slide in the back of the end zone. I mean, the rest of your day, that jersey is saturated. You've got mud and water dripping down your biceps and your forearms, and go to the sidelines and try and dry off and get back in there. That's going to be the problem. Those gloves, Kevin, are about done for today. They're just drenched.
It's going in places you didn't even know you had.
This part of the field, you have to be aware of Cooper and Crabtree on the fade route. They love to throw the fade route in this part of the field.
Chiefs a timeout. I love the pace and the speed, the tempo of this Raider offense.
Bill Musgrave does a great job getting the plays in quickly to Derek Carr. They want to give him extra time at the line of scrimmage to preview the front and the coverage. And a lot of their offense is predicated on Carr getting them into the best play possible based on the front and coverage.
And they give him a lot of freedom, don't they, Rich? He's only in his third year, but he has a lot of ways to maneuver.
He's earned that freedom and flexibility based on his performance. And I think, you know, he's got some history in the offense, and that's important. You know, when you've been together, this is his second year with Bill Musgrave, there's a certain trust factor that goes on between the play caller and the quarterback. It's a good look at Bill Musgrave right in the middle of your screen.
Second year, 48 years of age. He was a former NFL quarterback himself. He knows the position. Seventh play of the game, opening drive, third and goal for three.
You got to be aware of the fade route. These two players show up in this part of the field.
Caught. Flag. Parker defending. Holmes, touchdown. What a drive. 3-yard touchdown pass. And let's see what the flag is. I'm guessing it was on Parker. He didn't say it, but I'm guessing it's on Parker.
Well, Andre Holmes got him on the double move. Just watch right here. This is a really nice route and good patience by Andre Holmes. He's going to start him outside. He pauses and hesitates just enough to have Parker take a peek into the backfield, and a perfect catch and throw gets it done in the red zone.
Originally undrafted with the Minnesota Vikings, he's played with Dallas and now the Raiders. His second touchdown reception of the season on just his fifth catch for the Raiders this year. And Janikowski will try to belt this in, tag on one more. Raiders beat San Diego last week 34-31, first home win of the season. This is up and through, and 7-0 the Raiders with 11:58 to play. Cooper was terrific on the drive. Catches of 11, 18 and 11. And then they find Holmes in the back of the end zone for a Raiders 6. 11:58 in the first. Holmes with the touchdown reception in the back of the end zone for the Raiders on their opening drive. All set up by a Richard kickoff return of 50 yards. And a very nice drive engineered by Carr. The ensuing kickoff, Tyreek Hill is back from the one. He's a rookie out of West Alabama. He's out of Demetrius Harris block, and then he's shoved out of bounds by Shalik Calhoun. It is a 31-yard return, and a good one right there. With a look at quarterback Alex Smith of the Kansas City Chiefs, I think he'd admit it's probably not been the best start to a season for him.
No, it hasn't. And, you know, I think in talking with him last night, Kevin, he said we need to simplify some things and really get back to what we do well. Their core principles. I think that's always a good thing. Sometimes less volume is better.
Spencer Ware in the backfield, first and 10. Rolling here to buy some time. Macklin outside, covered by his former teammate Sean Smith. Macklin makes a gain of 4, and he's up to about the 35-yard line. Kansas City offense. Eric Fisher is going to have his hands full today with Khalil Mack. Schwartz has been the best offensive lineman so far, graded that way. Kelsey will operate well, they think, today against what is a soft spot with the Raider D. It's that linebacking core. Second down and 6. Sherman is in. It is the running back Ware who finds a hole and plummets his way to the 45. Smith brings him down in the secondary. A gain of 11, and a good one it was for Spencer Ware. The defense for the Raiders. We talked about Khalil Mack. 15 sacks a year ago, just one so far. He is due. Now they've added Bruce Irvin to the other side. He comes as a free agent from Seattle. And they like the pinch they give Mack and Irvin. In the secondary, we've already talked about Sean Smith. Emerson struggled last week against San Diego in the secondary, but he's had a good start to the season. There's a first and 10. Ware muddied already and stuffed at the line. Good stop right there by Stacy McGee, There is no game. They stay at the 45. Let's look deeper into these teams.
Well, let's look at the strength of the Chiefs right now. The running game, that's Charles, West, and Ware. And don't forget about Alex Smith. The weakness right now, pass protection. They've already given up 13 sacks. For the Raiders, the edge rushers, Mack and Irvin, are a handful. And finally, the weakness for the Raiders is secondary. They need to play better as they are last right now in pass defense.
DeAnthony Thomas, bottom of your screen. Yep, he's active for the first time this year. At the top of your screen, Hill. Second and 10. Whoops. Brought down on the play. There is Khalil Mack. First sack today. Second sack of the season. We'll be talking about 52 all day long. Back to the 43 with the loss.
Well, this is a good matchup. You're going to see Mack against Fisher. Look at the strength. He's used just that left arm. He pushes Fisher right down. Is able to get the sack on Alex Smith. Khalil Mack is a handful at the defensive end position.
You better believe it. Third and 11.
Eric Fisher needs to play well in this one. Mack has been quiet coming into this game, just a single sack through the first five games.
Hill, bottom of your screen. West was in the backfield. Oh, down he goes again. Shy of the first. Hit on the play by Danico Autry. He gained a yard, staggering ahead. He got as far as the 45, and the punting unit comes out there for Kansas City on their first possession.
Well, it starts with Mack because he forces Alex Smith to have to step up in the protection, and he falls right into the lap of Autry. Alex Smith told us last night he's got to be very conscious of his launch point with both Mack and Irvin coming screaming off the edge.
Justin Colquitt will punt. Wind is not picked up, but it's gonna. T.J. Carey is back. And gets a bounce. Carey picks it up, and Hill bounces him out of bounds inside the 20-yard line with a 5-yard return. 41-yard punt. Touchdown pass by Carr, 7-0 Oakland. 8:28 in the first.
NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest. Yes to low fares with nothing to hide. That's transparency. Verizon. Welcome to Verizon LTE Advanced, the next gen network. And by Ameriprise Financial.
Raiders have won three straight. First time in 5 years they've done that after the Kansas City punt, first and 10. Jumbo move.
Neutral zone infraction. Defense, number 51, jumped into the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Rich, they lost their terrific blocking tight end, Lee Smith, so they now put in a rookie tackle to act as a blocking tight end.
He's a monster, Kevin. You look at Denver Kirkman, and what they do is they have six linemen in the game now. You've got the extra tackle in there lined up on the left side of the offensive line. You think to yourself, if you're the Chiefs defensively, you got to be able to stop the runs to the left.
It's a first and 5, Washington. Right over that side where Kirkland was. He was back as he was crossing that first line there. Barry got him. Gain of 5 in the play. And he gets out to about the 29-yard line. The Kansas City defense with the Pro Bowler Dontari Poe in the middle. The pass rush has been an issue. The lack of it. And they need D4 to do more. Justin Houston is probably 3 weeks away, but is now beginning football activities. And Marcus Peters, who is from Oakland, is back home, leads the NFL in interceptions. First and 10. Derek Carr, blocked by Penn. Oh, and he's got his receiver, but it was underthrown, and Peters has picked him off! They were going for Crabtree, who slipped, and the ball picked off at the Kansas City 43. Peters with another pick. It's his fifth of the year. Coming back home and already making a dent in the game. Thursday, your weekend starts here when the Chicago Bears take on the Green Bay Packers in an NFC North battle. Thursday night football on CBS and NFL Network. After the Peters pick, his fifth of the year from the 43, it is first and 10, the fake to Ware. Kelce was blocking, then releases. And he's got a block from Conley, and he's belted out of bounds by Amerson. Running down the side, a 21-yard catch and run to the 36 of Oakland. First down.
And I'm not surprised to see the Raiders go after Marcus Peters with a double move. This is a nice job by Crabtree. He's got him beat. The only problem is that the quarterback can't set his feet. They've really struggled at the right tackle position. You see Austin Howard, he's going to get beat. That doesn't allow Derek Carr to set his feet and make a good, accurate throw down the field.
Three tight ends. Pistol, first and 10. Where? Kelce pulling and blocking. He's brought down by Smith. He grabs Ware and brings him down after a gain of 7. Joseph was in the vicinity as well. They get to the 29-yard line of the Raiders.
You have a note here, Kevin, when I look at Spencer Ware, ball security with a question mark. 3 fumbles already this season. It's a relatively new problem for him, especially when you consider he never fumbled the ball in college or in his first 3 seasons in the league.
Why is that happening? That's amazing.
And the problem is once you put it out there on film, then teams label you as a fumbler and they try and pop it out.
Second 3 draw play Ware. He began with Seattle and wrapped up on the play by Perry Riley Jr. Boy, was he good. Signed him off the street. The former Redskin allows just to gain a 2. They're down to about the 27-yard line.
Jack Del Rio talked about the energy that he brings to the mix. When you look at Perry Riley Jr., experienced veteran player that stepped right in, picked up the playbook and the system, and looks like a natural fit in the middle of that Oakland defense.
Starting for Malcolm Smith, 3rd and 1. Ware. And looks like he's pounded his way for the first. He picks up 2 and goes right into the teeth of that Raider D to the 25-yard line. Riley had a hand on him for the Chiefs, who have won 6 consecutive AFC West games. They won the first one they played this year, coming from behind in Kansas City against the Chargers.
Well, the one thing we do know about Andy Reid and his football team, Kevin, is they won't panic. I think back to last year, they won on opening day, and then they went on a sabbatical. They lost 5 straight, and then they peeled off 11 straight wins. This is a team that knows how to handle some adversity early.
First and 10. Fake to Ware, and they got the fullback, Sherman.
Alex Smith's pass.
Unfortunately, slips away. Second down coming up. Some notable inactives today. Nile Davis for Kansas City with the concussion is inactive. Latavius Murray is out. He's their top running back. He's gone. And Watson, their starting tackle, is out as well.
You look at the tackle not playing, Menelik Watson, Latavius Murray, it's really hurt their production in the running game. Kevin, they were really running the ball well the first 2 weeks. They've really fallen off in weeks 3, 4, and 5. Boy, communication has been a big issue for the Raiders. They had to burn a timeout there.
Timeout, Oakland, first team timeout, a 30-second timeout.
Why would you say it is?
I think part of the problem is they have 2 rookies at key spots. You've got a middle linebacker and a safety, Corey James and Carl Joseph. And that's really the lifeline of your communication system. The linebacker with the front 7 and the safety in the secondary, they've not done a good job. And what's amazing to me, we talk about it all the time, even in our business, how communication is critical. And you think about the average amount of time the ball is in play on the field in an NFL game, it's about 12 minutes. So it's really what happens between plays, on the sideline, in the huddle, at the line of scrimmage, that's just as important. And the Raiders have not done a good job with their communication on defense.
Kind of surprising. With NFL Game Pass, replay the games you miss with condensed games in 45 minutes or the full broadcast versions. Get the new midseason offer today at NFL.com/Game Pass.
And so what you're going to see from the Chiefs, Kevin, as a result of that, they'll give you different formations, different personnel groupings, shifts, motions, movement. Really put some pressure on these Raiders to communicate and make the adjustments.
Their tight ends are wide, 2nd and 10. Smith, Kelce, met and brought down. With a gain of 2 on the play and the hit by Corey James. He's the rookie out of Colorado State. Rich was just talking about him, got his first start a couple weeks ago.
Travis Kelce needs to be a big factor in this one. You talk about the importance of that position. It's the quickest way to the end zone is right down the middle of the field. It's also directly in the vision of the quarterback. And you think about the struggles, Kevin, the Raiders have had at linebacker and safety. Kelce needs to dominate in the middle of the field.
DeAnthony Thomas is out there, one of 3-1. Third and eight into the Raider nickel. Schwartz the block. Smith. And he's got Thomas very close to the first down. Dealing on the far side of the field with DJ Hayden, who was a top pick a couple years ago out of Houston. I think they've got it, and they do. Moving the chains. First down.
Well, he gets just enough. He has to come back for the ball a little bit. It's a good spot there by the official.
Or if it'll be challenged. Thomas with his first catch. First time he's been active this season. He presents all kinds of problems. Eighth play of the drive. West in the backfield. Chark Kendrick West. Dubonnet Goroff with a block. And out of bounds he goes. With a block from Kelce. And he's inside the 10. He picks up six. He's hit by Carl Joseph.
A real nice combination block there. You see Kelce, he's going to get the bump on the linebacker. Then he's up on the second level. Joseph, not the biggest safety. Kelce's become a complete player at that position. He's really improved as a run blocker, as an inline player.
Marcus Peters' interception sets up this possession for the Chiefs' second through. Jamal Charles is in. And the call. With the dance, hit by Nelson, look at him, dig all the way down to the two. What a play, that's on a completely reconstructed knee, pushing a couple Raiders back, picks up six, first and goal.
He is always a tough tackle, not the biggest back, but he can run with some power. He just gets lost inside behind all the big men. Question I have with Jamal Charles, Kevin, is where is he in terms of the conditioning? The running back position is all about strength, stamina, and endurance. And you can't get that without the live reps. He needs to play.
First and goal. Ware is in. Spencer Ware. Touchdown. A 2-yard run. Spencer Ware. And the Chiefs are within an extra point of tying the game. And the Peters interception, which leads pro football, sets up the possession.
Well, the Chiefs are a very good short yardage and goal line team. Do a nice job running the football in this part of the field. You see the push up front from the center, Morse, Fisher. Do a nice job getting up on the second level, giving Ware some space to run inside.
Important drive. Chiefs had it five plays in front of their first possession after the Raiders just buzzsawed through them for a 3-yard touchdown pass on their first drive. 10 plays and 57 yards. And Andy Reid, you said this before, after buys is 15-2, whether it was with the Eagles or the Chiefs. He knows what to do in getting the team ready.
And he told us last night, we need to play better up front, that offensive line. It tells you that they want to be able to run the football against this Raider defense.
Cairo Santos, and it lasers in, tying it at 7. So Peters picks off Carr. And the Chiefs move downfield, converting 2 third downs. Ware to the house for the Chiefs.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Fiat and by Bud Light. Make the right call. Drink responsibly.
Back in Oakland, the rain has let up a little bit, but it is still misty, and they expect this all day. Tied at 7 after the 2-yard touchdown run by Ware, set up on the Peters interception. Richard, he'll get it again. He returned his first kickoff today for 50 yards. And he is slipping around. Someone grabbed the face mask. He is brought down to the play by Albert Wilson and Sorensen. It's a 22-yard return. There is no yellow on the field. And the Raiders will get it again. They are 4-1 for the first time since 2002. And the Raiders in first place in the West. You're watching them against the Chiefs on CBS. Rivalry that goes back to 1960. They were called the Dallas Texans, taking on the Raiders then. And the Kansas City Chiefs. There's Leonard Ray Dawson, engineered so many of these things. Rich, you have been on both sides of this as a Chiefs starting quarterback and is the Raiders MVP and Super Bowl quarterback here in Oakland.
I got great appreciation for this rivalry. I want to apologize. I think that graphic may be wrong. 6-3 is a starter, Ken. I'm pretty sure it's better than that. Man. I'll have to go back and check it out in the media guy, but
doesn't really matter.
In all seriousness, this is special. There's no love lost between these two AFC West rivals.
I'm in the secondary for the Chiefs. This is Washington, the rookie, on a 1st and 10. You can see him corkscrewing into the secondary. He was hit by a couple, including Sorensen. Gain of 7 on the play. He's up to the 28-yard line. Daniel Sorensen making the stop. I mentioned Len Dawson. He is watching back in Kansas City. Leonard Ray is. Want to say hello to him. His wife, Linda.
That's a lot of great quarterbacks here today. You look to the left of us and Tom Flores and Jim Plunkett. We got a chance to visit with them before the game and hear their stories about their experiences in this rivalry. It's pretty awesome.
It's a 2nd down and 3. Arch Lillard got in there, limiting him to a gain of 1. Sambo there as well, with DeAndre Washington running the ball. And they get out to the 30-yard line. Let's take a look now when the Raiders have the ball against the KCD.
Well, Carr is playing as well as any quarterback in the game right now. We know that, Kevin. They're struggling to run the ball right now. They need more production from the tight end position. The Chiefs defense, they get good effort from their defensive line. Where their issues are right now is they're struggling getting to the quarterback. I can't imagine. For the life of me, they have just 5 sacks so far this season. Only the Giants have fewer with 4.
Olawale is in as a running back, 3rd and 2, into the middle. And they go outside. Seth Roberts, who's got the 1st down. He bumps off of Nelson. He's still alive, dancing his way, and Parker holding on for dear life. 19-yard catch and run, and a good one it was by second-year veteran Seth Roberts, taking it up to the Raider 49.
It's amazing. For some reason, they're just going to let him go, and he's just going to work to the flat. Sometimes you have your eyes in the backfield. They turn him loose in the flat. The corner doesn't come off for the second defender, and Roberts has a big play on 1st down.
That's hot!
A delay of game.
Oh. End of the quarter.
Wait.
Trying to get him to jump. Carr has thrown a 3-yard touchdown pass. Ware has had a 2-yard touchdown run. Tied at 7 on CBS. Rich, what'd you think of the first quarter?
Pretty even quarter of football, Kevin. Just the one big mistake from Carr that resulted in an interception. And, of course, the Chiefs were able to capitalize that on the touchdown run by Ware. When the weather is an issue, boy, ball security becomes a premium.
First play of the 2nd quarter, it's a handoff to Washington. Nice haul on that left side where they find most of their success. Johnson brings them down. Washington takes it down to the Kansas City 47, gain of 5. Well, tomorrow it's a night of full laughs, starting with all new episodes of TV's number one comedy, The Big Bang Theory, followed by TV's number one new comedy, Kevin Can Wait. Then don't miss the new Two Broke Girls and the season premiere of The Odd Couple. Only CBS. 2nd and 5. Still the nickel for the Chiefs. Carr. Cooper. Another catch for him. He picks up 3. Trying to chisel his way inside. Gets to the Kansas City 43 and hit by Bailey on the line.
Well, they love this under route with Amari Cooper. And he's patient. He comes off. It's another form of a slant. Look at the field, though. It's becoming an issue now. It's the 2nd straight play. We've seen a Raider player, Kevin, lose his footing. You know, we're below sea level here in Oakland. The field does not drain well. And if it continues to rain, it's going to continue to be an issue for both these teams.
Olawale is in 3rd and 2. Carr, 1st down, Crabtree. He slipped. Then jumping on his back was Phillip Gaines. It's a gain of 4. They move the chains to the Chiefs 38.
You know, Scott Kaplan showed us the different footing that the players are wearing. He talked about the longer cleats. I know a lot of players, Kevin, don't want to wear the longer cleats. They're worried about their foot sticking and getting a knee injury. So I was always reluctant to put the longer cleats on. But as the field continues to become an issue, we may see players go over to sidelines and make the change.
Down into the nickel for Derek Carr. On the move, chased by Zombo and belted by Peters. And a flag was thrown at the 44-yard line, and he picks up a yard on the play.
Holding, number 70, offense, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
That's Assembly, who is as good as there is at that position. So, Rich, you played on this field, and you know where the wet spots are, where it gets damp and doesn't drain very well.
Yeah, the outside the numbers is a real issue. Really, sometimes in the middle of the field, Kevin, you have those big 300-pounders in there, and eventually the middle of the field gets torn up pretty good. So that's always a factor, and it does affect how you call a game as a play call. Right now, you can see the Raiders trying to throw the ball a lot. It's apparent they have a big, massive offensive line. Difficult for the Chiefs to get any type of penetration.
Look at that right there on the first and 20 through the hands of Carr, and jumping on it was Washington alertly, and Ford taps him down back at the 49 and a loss of three. Scott Kaplan is on our sideline.
Kevin, as you guys are talking about, the field conditions are getting worse as the game is going on. You know, the tarp was on the field for a long time before the game, so it looked good to start, but it's a very soft surface because remember, they played baseball here until a few weeks ago. I talked to Sebastian Janikowski, the Raiders kicker, before the game. He said the field is actually under sea level, and that's why you get so many big puddles.
Good note.
Nowhere for the water to go.
Yeah. Second 23. Richard is in and has the handoff. Tries to pick and poke his way inside. Parker is there with the stop down about the Kansas City 47 with the gain of four. So you said minutes ago, you said you call the game differently. So walk me through that.
I think as a quarterback, Kevin, you come to the sidelines. These are the throws I'm comfortable making. You know, this is the receivers are telling me they're having a difficult time with the deep cutting, you know, outbreaking routes or whatever it is. So you have to find throws and plays within your system that you think you have a chance to be successful with. It's always a challenge. You never know how that ball is going to hit your hands as the quarterback. It's you come back with a lot of mud and dirt on it.
Six defensive backs, third and 20. Underneath they go. Cooper again. He's eating them alive. Sorensen jumping on his back, but he's short of the first down. Hits to the Kansas City 34. It's a 13-yard gain. Budrich, he gets him into field goal range.
Yeah, positive play there. Now Jack Del Rio has a decision to make. He's going to send out Janikowski, who's one of the best long ball kickers in all of football.
Best ever from 50 and beyond.
He still has, we watched him in pregame warm-up, he still has the big leg from outside 50.
So if Janikowski gets this field goal, he'll pass former Chief kicker Nick Lowry for number 12 all time in the scoring list. 52-yard try for the lead. High snap by Kondo. Missed wide left from 52. He misses. We stay tied at 7. The best big league in the game. Missing here from 52. Timeout. So the Chiefs defense limiting the Raiders to a field goal try of 52, which was missed. They hold on. We remain tied at 7. This is their resume so far.
Yeah, it's really no secret what the Raiders have to do defensively, Kevin. They have to stop the runs. The team that's committed to running the football. And then they have to defend the quick, short and intermediate throws, and that includes the screen game. This is a very good screen team in Kansas City.
Jamal Charles in. And another run right there. The tackle made by Mack. It is a gain of one. He's up to the Kansas City 43. Mack is very good against the run. We always talk about his sack prowess, and he's terrific there, obviously, but he can stop the run, too.
He is a complete player at that position. He's an unselfish player. He's willing to do the dirty work and play the run. Mm. And remember, he has gotten off the slow starts the last couple of seasons. We mentioned just the one sack coming into today's game. He finished with 15 a season ago.
Hill out of the backfield, second and 9. Here comes Tyreek Hill. He can make a lot of things happen. A 4-2-4 guy at the 40, and he picks up eight right there as he's down into Raider territory at the 49-yard line and hit on the play by Joseph.
Oh, trying to get the football to Tyreek Hill a little bit more. Kevin, you mentioned the speed. He has world-class speed. You can't underestimate his speed, and you can't overestimate your own speed. He's the fastest player on the field right now. They are in the early stages with him and just trying to find ways to get him more touches in this offense.
Charles in third and one.
Boy, a lot of movement, a lot of shifting.
Jamal Sherman, the block, and there he goes off to the races. He goes away. The block by Schwartz. He is hit on the play by Calhoun. He picks up 16 with a burst and a first down run for the Chiefs to the 32.
Well, you get the lead with the fullback, and then they're just going to follow it up with Charles, and he's patient enough to bounce it to the edge. He's just going to see this hole open up outside the right tackle, Duvernay-Tardif.
And they got Zach Fulton over there and Sherman. Also blocked by Demetrius Harris. First and 10. Charles is in. Jumping on him once again is Calhoun, who is the three-time Big Ten defensive player on that first team. Picks up two right there, down to the 30-yard line. Jamal. Well,
they have been very cautious with hurrying him along. He is their home run hitter, Kevin. He could score from anywhere on the field. I was told he had a great week of practice. They showed it should give him more touches and opportunities, and that's what he needs. He needs reps. He needs carries to get comfortable.
Second down and eight. Charles a block. That's the other thing he does well. And that is hauled in. Nice catch made by Albert Wilson. He had the matchup he wanted working on Mack, and that was a matchup that Alex Smith saw. 26-yard pickup, first and goal.
Again, you have to take some shots against this Oakland defense. Check out the blocking up front. See Jamal Charles. He picks up the corner off the edge. It gives Alex Smith just enough time to push the ball down the field.
First and goal at the four. Charles is in. Jamal blocked by Kelsey. Knifing his way in for six. 4-yard touchdown run. Jamal Charles is back. And the Chiefs have taken the lead for the first time today.
Well, you've seen a lot of window dressing, a lot of shifts and motions and adjustments, and they're really putting the pressure on this Oakland defense, Kevin, to do what? To communicate. And we knew that was a problem coming in. Not doing a good enough job making the adjustments with their front seven.
Two ACLs. He blew that knee against Chicago at Arrowhead, middle of October a year ago. It's been a long trek back. He carried two times against Pittsburgh, but back in full force today, and there's a missed extra point by Santos. First miss of the season. And it stays 13-7. Jamal Charles takes it in, and the Chiefs on top, 7-11, second quarter.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you got to get DirecTV. Chili's 3-for-me deal. Chillin' since 75. And by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
The Chiefs have beaten the Raiders three straight times, five of the last six. They had a good drive right there. They've had two consecutive scores, two consecutive rushing touchdowns. The ensuing kickoff by Santos, who just missed the extra point. Richard from the five. And stuck by Harris, the tight end, and then others come in to keep him shy of the 25. 20-yard return. Take a look at the Raiders in 7:05 in the second. The Oakland Raiders and the American Cancer Society hosted 14 breast cancer survivors and their family members at the Raiders headquarters. It was an evening of fun and fashion during the first annual Raiders BCA Fashion Show. Raiders presented a $5,000 check to ACS for their Look Good, Feel Better program and invited ladies to be the team's special guests at today's game. Nice moment beforehand. two rushing Kansas City touchdowns. Carr, a three-yard touchdown pass. That's where we stand. First and 10. Richard was back there. Carr with time. And he's got Cooper again having a big game hit by T.J. White, a rookie out of Georgia Tech. It's a first down throw, a gain of 12, up to his 36.
And Kevin, despite the rain in the first quarter, Derek Carr, 9 of 11. All nine of his completions are to his wide receivers. And if you're the Chiefs, you have to do something to disrupt the timing and the rhythm right now in the passing game. Carr has way too much time in the pocket. The problem with that is if you try and pressure him, he gets the ball out so quickly. So it's kind of a dilemma for this Chiefs defense.
He's up.
Richard on first and 10, shifting gears and cutting outside. Andre Jackson brings him down. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and he's up to the 42-yard line. Tonight on CBS, NCIS Los Angeles faces off against an assassin. Don't miss an action-packed new episode tonight after 60 minutes. Only CBS. Well, you said it, Rich. The quick release is the thing that is so tough to go against.
And you know, one thing that really I studied this week, Kevin, as I looked at Derek Carr, is in the quick game. He gets the ball out so quick in the gun. It reminds me a little bit of Aaron Rodgers. He has that type of release in the quick game from the gun.
Four defensive backs on second down and four. Here they dump it off, and it goes to Roberts, and quickly fouled there by Darren Johnson. Now, the interesting thing about Johnson, he has missed more tackles in his position than any other guy on the inside by Pro Football Focus's count. They throw him for a three-yard loss there, back to the 39.
Yeah, but by my count, he makes a ton of tackles, Kevin. In fact, he's the franchise's all-time leader in tackles.
Once again,
he leads this defense with 31 tackles. He makes a lot of plays sideline to sideline, and they've got to play better in front of him as well. But he is a ball hawk.
Hey,
a lot of communication going on up front on both sides of the ball.
Third and 7. Richard against 6 in the secondary, and they got Cooper working on T.J. White. He got the ball at the Kansas City 37-yard line. A 24-yard pickup. Amari Cooper having a huge day.
But the question is, does he get his feet in bounds? Looks like he taps the one down. The other
one's
a good catch on the boundary by Amari Cooper.
Boy, Carr, third down passing has been excellent, Rich, this afternoon for the Oakland Raiders.
5 of 5 on third down. 4 first downs to 4 different receivers. The thing I love about them, Kevin, in short yardage situations, they're not afraid to push the ball down the field.
Kansas City challenging the previous play of the catch at the sideline. Timeout.
I thought there was some green between his foot and the chalk on the sideline. They're reviewing this right here, working on the rookie, Amari Cooper. Timeout.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It's a catch. First down, Oakland.
Kansas City has one timeout left. With that challenge miss, 4:44 in the second quarter.
There you go back. They toe tap it. Good look right there. He gets both feet in bounds. Good concentration on the boundary by Amari Cooper.
Cooper has 7 catches and 93 yards already.
Yeah, you've got to be able to press these receivers at the line of scrimmage to disrupt the timing and the release.
Richard to the backfield, first and 10. Running for the chase. That's home. Upended there by Steven Nelson. The catch and run of 8 for Andre Holmes, who had the 3-yard touchdown reception in the first drive of the game for the Raiders.
The one thing Derek Carr does such a good job of, he throws the deep ball so well. He's so accurate, and he gets it up and down quickly before a safety can come over the top. He's got very good touch on a deep ball.
And they trust him, don't they?
Kevin, they call these shot plays from 4th and 2 and 3rd and 1. They're not afraid to throw the ball down the field in those type of situations.
Ready?
Second down, 2. He's stuffed right there, coming through. The rookie out of Mississippi State, Chris Jones, 2-time All-America. They throw him for a loss of 3, and he's back to the 33.
Well, this is a really nice play right in the middle of your screen. It was a nice job crossing the face of the tackle, Austin Howard. The back has nowhere to go. Good instincts there by Chris Jones.
The other thing they say about Carr, too, he comes from a football family. His brother, David Carr, was a former number 1 overall pick for the Houston Texans.
I think he learned a lot, Kevin, by watching that whole situation. David Carr had a tough go, but he got banged around a lot on a bad team in Houston. And
Certainly, Derek Carr learned a lot by watching his older brother.
Underneath third and five, he cannot find the handle. He bobbled it, and as you saw, could not reel it in. Coverage by Derek Johnson, who's having a good game. Carr had hit his last eight.
You like to think that Roberts can make this catch, but it's tough on the back shoulder when you're working across the field, and then you take a peek because you know you're going to get hit. I always say it doesn't hurt as much if you catch it the first time.
Yeah, easy for you to say.
You're going to get hit anyway. Just catch it. Doesn't hurt. Trust me.
Yeah, right. We're going to go for it, Rich, on fourth and five.
Boy, they have been aggressive. They have been as aggressive a football team, Kevin, as there has been in the league for the first 6 weeks.
She's had four in the secondary. Carr, he's got great touch. At that time, that is out of bounds and out of the reach and uncatchable for the receiver, Seth Roberts, who had plenty of company going down that sideline. And on downs, Del Rio and the Raiders give it back to Kansas City. There was pressure. There was coverage. And now the ball goes back to the Chiefs at 3:14. Coming up on the Verizon Halftime Report from our CBS studios in New York, JB, Tony, Bart, Boomer, Coach Cowher. Scores, news, highlights, and a preview of Thursday Night Football on CBS and the NFL Network. The Verizon Halftime next on CBS from the 32-yard line after on downs. Del Rio gambled on fourth and five at the Chiefs 32.
Kevin, I'm a little surprised they didn't give Sebastian Janikowski, their field goal kicker, a chance. I mean, that would have been a 50-yard field goal. They tried a 57-yard field goal earlier. He had plenty of leg, just missed it to the left.
Ware in the backfield, first and 10. There's a hole as he tries to go through, and it's only a 3-yard gain. Schwartz was leading the way. Tackle made by James. He's up to the 35-yard line. A couple times today, I've heard you talk about maybe some communications issues with the Oakland Raiders on defense.
And talking to Jack Del Rio on Friday, he said he instructed the coach just to stop talking so much in the meeting rooms and on the practice field. Put it back on the players. Good look at Ken Norton Jr., the defensive coordinator. You have to put the emphasis back on the players to communicate on the field.
Second and seven, going deep, and he's got Macklin with a nice catch. They beat Amerson. Boy, has he struggled the last couple of games. He struggled against the Chargers. Amerson did. Big hit for Macklin. 38-yard pickup, 27-yard line.
Pretty good coverage by Amerson. He just doesn't do a good enough job locating the ball early enough, and a perfect throw there by Alex Smith. Puts it on the outside for Jeremy Macklin.
And Macklin has not had his usual season. He's had four drops, and some of the routes that he ran last year so successfully have not given him the kind of success this year for the Chiefs.
Kevin, one of the things the Chiefs have to do a better job of is taking some shots down the field. Make these corners play. You can't give them a free pass. You have to make them defend the deep ball.
Chiefs with two rushing touchdowns lead at the two-minute warning in the first half on CBS. From New York, CBS will give you the Verizon Halftime Report with JB and company. Scores, news, highlights, and a preview of Thursday Night Football on CBS and NFL Network on the Verizon Halftime Report. Chiefs have one timeout, lead on two rushing touchdowns, first and 10 from the 27 after the completion of 38 to Macklin, and Jamal Charles is in. Charles going the other way, Fisher with the block on Mack, Conley with the block, and they still fight through. Nice play there by the rookie out of West Virginia, Carl Joseph, on a gain of three. They bring him down to the 24.
He's a good tackler, Kevin. Their first round pick out of West Virginia. Really enjoyed sitting down and visiting with him on Friday. Said he wanted to be a corner in college, but when the coaches at West Virginia saw him tackle in their first spring practice, they immediately moved him to safety. He is a physical run support player. He had an interception last week and a fumble recovery. He will show up.
Second down, seven. Smith is at five in a row. Six in a row. Conley to the 18. Amerson with the hit. And a gain of six on the play. Shy of a first down by a yard. So it'll be third and one. And again, the Chiefs with one timeout. And Andy Reid wants some quiet.
We've got plenty of time here, Kevin, with a minute on the clock. Other ways to stop the clock.
Third and one. And the Chiefs this season, perfect. 6 of 6. Clock rolls. Third and one. Ware. Oh, what a defensive play. Rolling in there, Stacy McGee, who had a good game last week with a couple sacks, and that is a 2-yard loss back to the 20. And the time continues to tick.
Well, that'll make Andy Reid sick. They rolled the dice, tried to run it on third and one.
Now they've got to kick the field goal. Look at the penetration. Look at the push right there. The back has nowhere to go. Good look at Bruce Irvin in the backfield as well.
Raiders a timeout. So, Rich, going back to where you opened the show, pretty important game, even though we're just in week six here early in the season. If it's a win for the Chiefs and Andy Reid, they go to 2-0 in the division and 3-2 overall. And with Denver losing the other night to San Diego, and if the Raiders would lose today, things become even. If they lose, though, they'd be 2-3 behind the 5-1 Raiders. That is a pretty big deficit, and Denver would be a couple up on it.
And these divisional games always mean so much. Kevin, I think to go on the road in a division and win, it's maybe the hardest thing to do in football, and that's a challenge for the Chiefs. They're coming off the bye week. We know how successful Andy Reid has been off the bye week, 15-2 as a head coach. This team is well rested.
Santos, who had his first missed field goal of the season last week, and a missed PAT today, will try from 38. Another miss.
Wow.
He's missed 2 in 2 weeks, and he's missed two today. 1 point after, and that 38-yard field goal try, and the score stays 13-7.
Well, it looked like a good snap and a good hold. Gets the laces where they want them. He just tugs it a little bit to the left. It's like my pitching wedge from about 120 yards.
And your driver.
Into the bunker.
And your 5-iron. Now, what about footing? I mean, the plant is so important for these kickers, and we know it's a soggy field.
Kevin, you know, I was watching in pregame warm-up both kickers. The whole process is slowed down just a tad. The holder wants to make sure he catches the ball cleanly, and the slight hesitation sometimes is just enough to affect the timing and the rhythm for these kickers.
Oluwole, 1st and 10 with the timeout. Once again, Van Cooper. The catch for him, his 8th, and he's close to a 10-yard pickup. He gets the ball out to about the 37-yard line and a gain of 9. They're not going to take it. Well, there they go with the timeout. So timeout taken by the Raiders. They are out of timeouts. We'll be the first to know your team's news with the CBS Sports app. Get instant updates, expert analysis from guys like Rich Gannon, highlights and more. Download the CBS Sports app today.
Remember now, they could pick up 20, 22 yards. You give your Pro Bowl kicker, Sebastian Janikowski, at least a chance at it, a good look at it.
Missed field goal at 38. That's the Raiders start at their 28. They just got Cooper. Cooper, by the way, 8 catches and 102 yards. It is his 8th career 100-yard receiving game. Boy, is he good.
But Crabtree's been quiet, Kevin. Just the one catch for 5 yards. You got to keep an eye on him as well.
Chiefs have a timeout. Raiders are out. 2nd and 1.
And look at the off coverage up top. My goodness, that's where the ball has to go.
6 defensive backs for the Chiefs. Carr. Cooper. Out of bounds with White right there. Caught it at the 48 of the Chiefs. 14 seconds, 15-yard pickup. 1st down.
Well, look at the concentration. He gets the left foot down. He's able to drag the right foot. Kevin, I suppose if you got a receiver that's hot right now, you got to keep feeding him the ball.
Well, it has been Crabtree. Although Cooper's gotten the bulk of the catches in terms of number, Crabtree's been getting the touchdown reception.
And if you're Bob Sutton, the defensive coordinator for the Chiefs, you have to do something. You have to help these corners. Cooper's on a roll right now at 9 catches for a 117.
Chiefs have gotten 4 guys lined up on the 20-yard line way downfield. 1st and 10 underneath. And this tight end is going to roll. Clive Wolford, inactive last week because of a knee. And he has an 18-yard pickup, and they got to chalk it. 3, and he gets it with a 2nd left. Or did they? Yep, they did.
Well, look at the field. Look at all the emptiness there. He should have actually gone down a little bit earlier, but they do a nice job. This is something that was
was talked about, has been rehearsed. They do a great job of trying to get the ball spotted. What the tight end should have done is should have handed the ball to the official. That's the first mistake, but they do a good job clocking it anyway.
Minimal wind, 45-yard try. Make it 46-yard. They just moved it back a yard. King on the hold, three on the board. 13-10 at halftime. The Chiefs will lead. As the Raiders score, the Chiefs missed a 38-yard field goal. The Raiders get a 45-yard field goal from Sebastian Janikowski. And it's a 13-10 halftime in this terrific rivalry with the Chiefs and the Raiders. Chiefs come in winless on the road at 2-2. Carr and the Raiders are in first place in the AFC West at 4-1. Carr through the air, 15-20. Alex Smith through the air, 8-9. Chiefs have a couple of rushing touchdowns. Two from Ware. 2-yard touchdown run from Ware. Charles with a 4-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders have scored on that just seen 45-yard field goal and a 3-yard touchdown pass. Carr to Andre Holmes.
A 6-point swing there.
On a wet day in Oakland. 46-yard field goal. Scott Kaplan is on our sideline.
Coach, we talked on Friday about coaching aggressively, and you chose to go for it on fourth down when earlier Janikowski had plenty of leg on a field goal that was missed. Can you take us through that decision?
Yeah, I made a decision. Didn't work out. Came back, did a great job here at the end of this half of holding them out and then going down with a limited amount of time and getting a field goal.
All right, what do you do about this offense, getting it going? It got off to such a hot start and then slowed down.
Just got to make our plays. Offensively and defensively, our plays are there to be made. Nice ball game. Down three. We've been down worse than that. We've got a lot of football in front of us, and we're excited about the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you so much. Good luck to you. Back up to you, Kevin.
Yeah, they've been down a lot, actually. They have 2 1-point wins and a 3-point win, and all five games decided by 7 points or less, and that's where they are again. Trailing by three at halftime on CBS. Raiders to within three, Chiefs on top after having a bye last week. Let's now take a look at Who Are You Lovin', presented by McDonald's. Led by fullback Anthony Sherman and tight end Travis Kelce. It's Jamaal Charles with one of two rushing touchdowns for the Chiefs today. With former Chief and Raider quarterback Rich Gannon, Kevin Harlan. We had a 6-point swing there at the end of the first half.
Yeah, that's got to be a concern right now, Kevin, for Andy Reid. Carlos Santos missed an extra point and a field goal. Big 6-point swing. The Raiders were able to go down and get a field goal from Sebastian Janikowski. Plays in the kicking game. We always talk about how critical the special teams are because every play in the kicking game equals points and field position. You look at some of the adjustments here in the second half. Obviously, the Chiefs have to keep the mix going. They've had a good mix of offense and defense, or offensive production with the running game. Raiders have to find a way to slow down Amari Cooper. He's on a roll right now. He's had 9 catches for 117 yards. When you look on the other side of the football, Raiders have to continue to push the ball down the field. And a guy that has to get some touches in the second half, Michael Crabtree, just 1 catch for 5 yards.
It's the goalpost on the kickoff by Janikowski for Tyreek Hill. Chiefs will have it first and 10 with a touchback to the 25 to the sideline, and Scotty Kaplan.
Kevin, I walked the field during halftime, and between the hashes, it is really torn to shreds. It's a very loose turf, so the turf is coming up easily, making it very hard for these guys to get their footing in. From the kicking game standpoint, the balls are starting to absorb the water, making them very heavy. Now, Janikowski obviously didn't have a problem with it, but we've already seen Cairo Santos on the Kansas City side have his fair share of issues, Kevin.
Scott, thank you. Ware in the backfield. Here comes Alex Smith. 8 of 9 in the first half, 1st and 10. And play action with a block by Ware. And Chris Conley, who up to today has been the number one rated wide receiver with this team. James makes the stop, the rookie linebacker. 13-yard pickup to the 38, first down.
If the Raiders are vulnerable, it's in the middle of their defense. We talked about the challenges as they have with the rookie linebacker Corey James and the rookie safety Carl Joseph with communication. But Malcolm Smith, Corey James, not the best cover linebackers. And they struggle a little bit at the safety position right now with Reggie Nelson, who's given up some big plays in the passing game as well.
First and 10, throw outside. Kaplan Get a bounce by Anderson about the 45-yard line. And a pickup of 7 on the play through 30 minutes of football. These are the numbers.
I thought it was a pretty even half of football. The one turnover from Derek Carr was the real difference there in the first half. The Chiefs were able to capitalize on that. The missed extra point and the missed field goal. It's a real turning point there late in the first half for the Oakland Raiders.
Three tight ends. Base defense. Second and three. Quickly out with great rhythm. Conley, the second-year wide receiver out of Georgia. First down reception near the 48-yard line. On him was Sean Smith. Pickup of 7.
That was interesting last night in talking with Alex Smith, his former teammate Sean Smith. They know each other so well. They went against each other in practice for a couple of years. And you look at how Sean Smith decides to play these receivers. I think he's a much better cornerback when he comes up to the line of scrimmage, Kevin, and presses and gets his hands on these receivers. I don't think he's nearly as effective when he plays from off coverage.
The tight ends again on first and 10. Ware, Sherman a block that opens the door, and there goes Spencer Ware. Deep into Raider territory, taken down in the secondary by Nelson. A 45-yard gallop put him at the Raider 3, first and goal.
Well, they do a really nice job. You're going to see Kelsey. He's going to block down. They pull the tackle. Well, look at the wall that's created on this left side of this offensive line. Smith needs to play with his outside shoulder. He needs to force that run back up inside. That's just too easy for Spencer Ware.
He got to knock him out of bounds, and Smith couldn't do that. Look at another 10-plus yards for Ware. Drafted by Seattle in 13, off the Chiefs practice squad. First and goal at the 3. Charles is in. Hill at the top of your screen. It's an end around. Macklin, he wants to throw, and he throws it away. And no one was home. No one was on that side of the end zone, Rich.
But he gets treated as a quarterback as well, Kevin. He's outside the tackle box as long as he gets it back to the line of scrimmage. That's a good alert play there by Jeremy Macklin. This is something that they rehearsed. This is just something he did on his own. If it's not there, the prudent thing to do is throw the ball away and avoid a negative play.
And outside the tackles and no intentional grounding. Macklin, who last year caught 87 balls and single season Chiefs record. There's a couple catches today. Second goal of the 3. Charles remains. Hill in motion. Jamal Charles near the goal line. And with Bruce Irvin and others right there making the stop, including Reggie Nelson, he moves him that much closer.
A lot of the running game is about illusion and disguise. You see the motion, you get the sense that maybe they're going to hand the ball to Tyreek Hill. If you're a linebacker, you take your eyes off the lone back, Jamal Charles. They have really hurt this Raider defense running up inside between the center and guards.
Chiefs have run on every 3rd and 1. They got a 3rd and goal at the 1.
Look at all the shifting and all the movement.
Poe is in, 92 off the line. It's Poe, the catch, a bulldozing move, and a touchdown. Dontari Poe, the big man rumbling in. What a catch.
What a play. What a design. Who thinks to throw the ball to their defensive tackle? Dontari Poe.
You give him a week off, and this is the kind of stuff they come up with.
Well, look at all the movement. You're going to see them shift out. Here's Dontari Poe. He's in the back. He was in the backfield initially, and then he lines up in that bunch set. You see the 3 big men up in front block, and he just does the rest. He looks like he knows what he's doing. He lowers the boom.
That's a terrific play. How fun.
Look at Andy Reid. He loves it. A former offensive lineman, like the big man. You want to get the big guys some touches.
Poe has scored before in San Diego, you may recall.
They use him in the short yards.
Yes,
goal line.
They do. Biggest man to score a touchdown. Santos. He puts this one through, and the Chiefs lead by 10. They're going to call it a rush by Poe. It is not a catch, although he got it. But see, he throws it backwards. Then Poe, head down, pile drive. Poe played all the skill positions in high school. He just kept getting bigger and rounder and
healthier.
And healthier.
Oh, I love having fun with the big guys.
Second rushing touchdown for him. The ensuing kickoff. Charles had a 50-yard return today. Leaves it in the end zone, going to an 8 to the 25-yard line. Dontari Poe, a Pro Bowler on the defensive line, and he likes the end zone as well. Raiders have been down in three of their four wins in the second half, and here they are down again. Denver Kirkland is in as a blocking tackle outside for Cooper on first and 10. The coverage and the play by White on the missed shot there by quarterback Derek Carr. There's Scott Kaplan on the sideline.
Kevin, two injuries to report from the Kansas City sideline. Starting defensive tackle Alan Bailey, he was listed as probable in the first half. He's been downgraded now to questionable with a shoulder injury. And cornerback Philip Gaines is now out with a knee injury.
He started today, Gaines did. He started the first three games. He was inactive last week against Pittsburgh because he tweaked his knee in practice. Thank you, Scott. Second down and 10. Washington is in. The good block by Austin Howard, playing the right tackle and pulling, and then brought down below the knee by Ron Parker. Gain of 7 on the play to the 32.
Well, you mentioned the Raiders, Kevin, their ability to come from behind. I think they've been a much better team late in games, which, as we know, was a problem in the past. They've won four games by a total of just 12 points, as you point out, but they've been a good finishing team late. They have the ability to strike quickly with Derek Carr.
Carr's the best fourth quarter quarterback in the league. Numbers say it, results say it. Third and 3. To the Kansas City dime, incomplete. Peters is there covering the running back on the cross, DeAndre Washington. Here comes the punt unit for the Raiders.
Well, the protection was fantastic, but at some point, you have to make a decision. Go ahead and run it. Pretty good coverage here by the Chiefs, but I believe there's an opportunity right here to run for the first down.
He can run, right?
He only needed 3 yards.
Marquette King to punt. And there was a flag. Tyreek Hill is back. He's the number 9 punt returner in the league. He dances on Holmes and gets by him. On the move, here come the blocks. He's looking for one from Sherman. The explosive rookie is finally tackled with a shoestring at about the 45-yard line and brought down on the play by the Raiders' Brendan Trowick. He tripped him up, and a flag down at the 29. Do I count two out there or one? Flags. Maybe just the one.
I thought this was offsides Oakland.
58-yard punt and a 50-yard return by Hill.
Illegal formation, kicking team. The 5-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down, Townmeyer.
This Hill is an exciting guy. His longest punt return was 32 yards at Houston. He just beat that with a 50-yarder against the Raiders. Hill was kind of a controversial pick out of West Alabama. Began his college career at Oklahoma State. He just returned a punt 50 yards, career high. And he's with the Chiefs at the 36-yard line of the Raiders with a first and 10. Ware in the backfield. Smith has hit his last 9 with a fake and time and Ware. And Ware got by one linebacker, that was Irvin, and brought down by another. And that was Corey James, the rookie, a 30-yard catch and run. And he takes it to the 6, first and goal, Kansas City.
The play action's been so effective. You see the stretch fake to where Alex Smith wants to throw the crossing route. It's not there. He works all the way back across the field. Talked about tackling. Another missed tackle by the Raiders.
By the way, Ware is number 1 in yards after catch. First and goal at the 6. Ware, maybe the 4. In that big sea of black uniforms, Joseph at the bottom, gain of a yard, put him at the 5. Ellis was there, and look at the consistency of...
It's a pretty good report card, isn't it?
Quarterback Alex Smith, looks like your report card.
You know, the thing I love about Alex Smith, Kevin, he doesn't make very many mistakes. He's as good as there is at taking care of the football, especially in these wet weather games. He makes great decisions, and he doesn't put his team in harm's way.
Hill in the backfield. Timeout. Somebody was lined up wrong. Whether it was Macklin or Kelsey or O'Shaughnessy, somebody was not right. How do the play calls come in for the Chiefs? How's their communication? There's Matt Nagy right there, the assistant offensive coordinator.
Yeah, they got Brad Childress, the co-offensive coordinator. He's up in the booth. Andy Reid calls the plays. And, you know, Matt Nagy's there as well, and he helps him. The thing about Andy Reid...
Nagy is the one who actually communicates in the helmet, right?
He calls the plays into the quarterback. But the great thing about Andy Reid that I've always admired as a play caller, Kevin, is his patience. His patience with the running game. And that's, you know, everything starts with their running game. You know, Alex Smith threw it 50 times the last time out versus Pittsburgh. They only ran it 18 times. Those numbers are out of whack for a run-first team. And if they're not able to run the ball successfully, they usually struggle on offense.
DeAnthony Thomas is in the backfield. Second and goal at the four. Smith, where? Round about the two-yard line. And picks up two on the play. Joseph makes the hit, the rookie. Third and goal.
Chiefs do talk a lot about the screen game. The Chiefs run more screens than any team in the league. They haven't run much of that today, Kevin, because of the field conditions. You know, screens are good when you got a team that's screaming off the edge, rushing the passer. When you're not able to put your foot in the ground and do that, it makes it a little bit more difficult to draw the rush.
There are going to be three tight ends at the bottom of your screen. Third and goal at the two.
Empty backfield. Quarterback draw.
Smith. Charles devoured. Emerson. And it's a loss of two. He's back near the 3 or 4.
Really nice job by David Emerson sorting it out, working through the trash there and making a tackle. Here's a guy that has struggled with some tackling in the open field the last couple weeks. Good alert play there by the veteran corner.
It's a field goal here by the Chiefs, and that unit is on the field right now, still makes it a two-score game. ...22-yard field goal. ...23-10, the Chiefs. So the Raiders hold them out of the end zone with some nice D.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by State Farm. Talk to an agent today at 800-STATE-FARM. And by McDonald's. I'm loving it.
Oakland in the foreground, San Francisco, and all connected in the background, and then all connected by the Bay Bridge. Chiefs have had 5 red zones today, 3 touchdowns, 1 field goal, 1 missed field goal. After his 23-yarder, Santos will boot this downfield. Richard from the 4. Boy, can he fly? He has acceleration. And Sherman brings him down, the fullback, on a 17-yard return. Moments ago, Marcus Peters leaves the field. And Scott Kaplan. Samari Cooper.
Yeah, he's had a big day, Kevin. Now you've got Peters out. Gaines is out. They're already thin at corner. And Derek Carr has really thrown the ball well. 15 of 22 for 169 yards. The Chiefs have to do something to disrupt the timing a little bit and the rhythm of the passing. They need to speed up Derek Carr.
Eric Murray has come in as one of those defensive backs. Richard on first and 10. Brought down by Derek Johnson. No gain on the play. They'll stay at about the 21.
You look at Cooper, Kevin, the Chiefs have to do something to slow him down a little bit. You look at those numbers there. First open receiver since Jerry Rice have 9 catches in the first half. I was a part of that. Jerry was on fire. I don't think Tim Brown is too happy about that, but I can't imagine Crabtree's happy. They've got to find a way to get him some touches as well.
Down at 10, Richard. The bench right there. Got by Ali, and then he's finally brought down by Tamba and by Nelson. It is a gain of 6. He takes it out to the 27-yard line. So Gaines is out with a knee injury again, and Peters is still gone.
And that puts a lot of pressure on Bob Sutton, the defensive coordinator, Kevin, that the pass rush has struggled. They have just 5 sacks so far this season. They really missed Justin Houston. Tamba Ali hasn't been 100% healthy. He's not been playing every snap. It puts a little bit more of the emphasis on their coverage units. DJ White has to play better. Steven Nelson.
Including Sorensen. They've got 6 back there in the secondary, 3rd and the short, 4. And Sorensen was all over Richard. The drop ball. The punting unit takes the field.
Well, there's no excuse for this. This hits him right in the numbers. Have to make that catch. Can't let it get on your body. Extend those hands.
Second consecutive 3 and out for the Oakland Raiders in first place and trying to win their fourth consecutive game.
I'm not so sure, Kevin, I'd give Tyreek Hill a chance to field this ball.
Well, we'll see what happens.
He is a problem right now for the coverage units for the Raiders.
50-yard return already moments ago. And again, King lets it fly. He wants the fair catch and makes it. Hang time was 4:53, so they got down there and covered well. 49-yard King bunt. 6:10, third quarter on CBS. Screening saves lives, and the NFL and the American Cancer Society encourage everyone to join in the fight against breast cancer. Learn more about A Crucial Catch Day on October 25th. Find out how you can help make a crucial catch at NFL.com/pink. So here is Alex Smith and that offense. They've hit with him throwing 12 consecutive passes, Rich. And they've scored the last two times they've had it. A one-yard touchdown run and a 23-yard field goal.
They've been very efficient, Kevin. They've done a nice job with their play selection. 20 runs, 17 passes. Alex Smith, 14 of 15 for 170 yards.
Three tight ends. Anger playing the left guard right now for Fulton. They've been going back and forth. Charles is in. Jamal Charles on first and 10. There's a block downfield by Carl Joseph. Joseph, the rookie, making the stop. Gain of a yard to Scott Kaplan.
Kevin, from the Kansas City Chiefs sideline, their star cornerback, Marcus Peters, has left the field, gone back to the locker room. The Chiefs Public Relations Department reporting that he's taking intravenous fluids, and they expect him back.
But IV drip, better hurry. You need him back quickly.
No drip, how about a flow? Second line. Thomas, top of your screen, receiver. Into the nickel. Progressions made. And a nice catch by Hill on the fly. He played very little wide receiver in college. He picks up 11 right there. He's hit by Sean Smith, the former Chief, and he's up to the 37 with the first down.
And they're just in the early stages with Tyreek Hill. Kevin, this offensive staff just trying to figure out what he's comfortable doing, what he can handle. And they don't really think of him as a gadget guy. He is a player that can play all three wide receiver positions in this Kansas City offense.
Kind of like Tavon Austin maybe with the Rams.
He is very similar. He has the same short area quickness that you see with Tavon Austin.
Fake to him. Charles is in. Gets the call. He's a great pass catcher. He's chased by the rookie down the sideline, Corey James. And his speed turning the corner to the 47 of Oakland. A catch and run of 16. Here comes Peters. Fully hydrated, we think, and back out there for Kansas City after Charles had a nice play.
Just keep an eye on the middle linebacker. He has a ways to go to cover this play. He takes the step. He's got Jamal Charles. He's got to work underneath the crossing defender, and he just gets outflanked by the quicker Jamal Charles.
We thought Kelsey would be a big story. Nothing to him since late in the first quarter at the tight end.
And I thought he was going to have a huge day against this Oakland secondary.
First and 10, Charles. Malcolm Smith gets him, the former Super Bowl MVP with Seattle, throwing him for a two-yard loss. So Charles has carried it nine times for 34 yards. Charles has caught two for 14. That's his day.
This is a critical possession or series for this Oakland defense, Kevin. They have to find a way to get off the field on third down. Down by two scores, can't allow Kansas City to put another score on the board. To find a way to get a stop here in this possession.
Where is in? With a second, 13 underneath, and he finds the receiver, DeAnthony Thomas, who is hit by linebacker Bruce Irvin, picks up six, making it third and seven for the Chiefs from the Raider 43.
Well, the Chiefs are doing a terrific job just working the underneath zones against this Oakland defense, really putting some stress on the linebackers. Bruce Irvin, he doesn't want to cover, he wants to rush the passer. It's a little bit out of his element when you ask him to cover tight ends and receivers in the middle of the field.
Six defensive backs. Charkendrick West is in, third and seven.
Here comes the blitz.
Blocked by West. Smith, oh, he's got him, and he tripped, and it was almost picked off by Nelson going for Conley. A lot of moving parts on that play. Smith thought there may have been a shove. No yellow on the field. Fourth and seven. Punting unit comes out for Andy Reid.
Nonetheless, a really good angle by Reggie Nelson. See, and he could have made this interception. He had a chance, a real good chance at this. Just got to squeeze it.
Well, he and Peters led the NFL with 8 interceptions apiece last year.
Alex Nelson. Smith wants a pass interference call there.
He does. So here's the punt by Colquitt. Carry. Fair caught in front of Hill inside the 10. Good hang time of 5-4. 36-yard well-placed punt with hang time. Week 6 continues with Sunday Night Football on NBC and then Monday Night Football on ESPN and Westwood One Radio. Then Week 7 kicks off with Thursday Night Football on CBS, NFL Network, and streaming on Twitter. Next week, Rich and I, you're not going to be with me. What am I saying?
London's calling.
We will be in London next week. This crew will. Dan Fouts and I will be in London for the Giants and the Rams on NFL Network. Seen in LA and in New York.
Darcy! Now! Hey, Rudy! Darcy! Rudy! Express! That's it!
From the 8th, first and 10. Some dancing here by Andre Washington. DeAndre Washington takes it out. Finally, Poe will fall on him. With a gain of 7 on the play, they'll be near their own 15-yard line. DeAndre Washington, a 5th-round pick out of Texas Tech, the number 5 rusher all time. Peters is ready, hat goes on, and he'll go back out there for Kansas City.
He's got the tape where they had the IV in there.
Yep, good call.
Right arm. Had enough of them. I know where they put that IV stick.
Can they turbo-inject it into your face?
Raiders struggle a little bit here in the second half. Kevin, just 6 plays, 13 yards, 2-3 and outs. Need to get something going here.
They told the right calf was cramping to Peters. There's a tackle made in the secondary by Ron Carter on the run by rookie DeAndre Washington. It is a gain of 6 and a first down for the Raiders. They're up to their 21.
Well, they ham and egg it a little bit with their running game because of their personnel. They're without the starter, Latavius Murray. We talked about the changes that they've had at the right tackle position. They've used 5 different right tackles. Austin Howard is getting a start there today. And they will mix it up with both Washington and Richard at the running back position.
Cooper hasn't caught anything in the second half, at 9 in the first half. Blocked by Penn, a good one it is. They go outside here, caught by Crabtree, he's been quiet. They were working with DJ Wright at the gain of 5 up to the 27. Tonight, it's one of the most difficult issues in the election. Our Syrian refugees coming to the U.S. without proper vetting. Find out tonight on 60 Minutes. Make the packages, all the different substitutions that go on, play to play, down to down.
The game has really become all about traditional football, Kevin. It's first down package, second long, medium, third, 2-4, 5-7, 8-12, red, minute.
5 into the nickel. Time. Almost intercepted by linebacker Austin Mark Lillard. Stir all season. Of last year, he was at the back starting this year. And second year back, had to go right through his hands.
I don't think he ever feels linebacker back up underneath this. He's late with his eyes. He never feels the linebacker, and that's just a poor decision by Mar. I mean, Mars Lillard is right there to make the play.
Boga injured in the hip that opened up the spot. Mars Lillard in there. The season 3rd and 5. With backup Howard. And off the field of Cooper. Nice pressure by Chris Jones on that line. Here comes a booze and 5 plays punt for the Raiders.
This is pretty good coverage. He knows he has help inside. He tries to under this. Making a perfect throw from Derek Carr to get this one done. A little bit too high, too far in front of Amari Cooper.
Hill back there. He's had 2 return touchdowns. Call back. 178 return. 105. Touchdown returns were called back because of penalties. A 50-yard return here this afternoon from Marquette.
He's going to have some room, too.
He sure he is.
Up the field, field.
And a whole protection. Long way trolley for the Raiders. 51-yard punt with a roll to the 20. Mark King. Well, Saturday. 23 seconds to go.
Good look at Andy Reid, Kevin. They've got to be patient.
Here's what I was going to say. Saturday, best game from the best conference. Texas A&M taking on number one Alabama. It all begins with college football today. Here on CBS. Pistol Ware. Pitch out. Mack is chasing. Ware is hard to bring down. Hit by Malcolm Smith. Close to a 10-yard. Out to his 31-yard line, first and 10. Justin Ellis was there as well off the line.
We saw that very play in week one against Diego,
he did, yes.
Right?
Yes, sure did.
To win it.
You got a good
little option. Right.
On the Chiefs lead on three runs. There's Derek Carr. And the way the man, this is not showing what the first place have been all over here lately. They've been playing so well.
Another playing here in the third game as it comes. Kansas City, 148 yards of offense in the fourth quarter. The Raiders just 9 yards as the game continues to pick up here in the fourth quarter.
Second one, where by Sherman, in fact, he bounces like a pinball off of 39. Brought down by Smith, he picks eight on second one. Kansas City first 39-yard line.
And Ken, when you have these type of conditions where the rain is a factor, I think it really benefits the team that's able to run the football effectively and clearly. That's the Kansas Chiefs. They have backs. They have a quarterback that's willing to be involved, an active participant in the running game. And you look at the Raiders, they have really struggled to run the football the last 2 weeks.
The three times first and ten. What is that taken off? He gets out just beyond the 40 with the gain on the play. Where? 89 yards. Ellis makes the stop for the Raiders.
And if you're Alex Smith, you have to be conscious of the play clock. I want to use all of it in between plays. When we're running the football, I want to make sure I take that play clock all the way down inside 5 seconds every play.
Matt Nagy, rising star. Him and Brad Childress, a great combination. Childress with the incredible reputation and resume. Second down and 8. Where again? 90 yards and adds to that. Brought down by linebacker Corey James, taking the play to the injured Ben Heaney out of Kansas. Calhoun makes the stop as well. It's a gain of 9. He's shy of midfield and shy of 100. And looks like we've got James trying to catch his breath. The Chiefs last season, Rich, swept all 3 road games in the division, winning at San Diego, Denver, and Oakland.
We were talking to Alex Smith last night about his success against the Oakland Raiders. Kevin, he's played some of his best football in the division against the Raiders, and especially on the road here in Oakland.
And as a Niner, he beat him. He's, 7-1 against the Raiders. 18 touchdowns and 3 picks coming into today.
I think his last 3 games here in Oakland, he's thrown 9 touchdowns and no picks.
Wow. First and 10.
Raiders got to, they got to come up with a play here. They've got to do something to get the ball out or get a stop here.
Harry Riley is in, taking the place of the injured linebacker. They send in Ware, who picks up 3 and finds himself at the Raider 47. Putting together the Subway postgame show for you from our CBS studios in New York right now, time permitting. JB and Company, scores, highlights, and news. The Subway postgame show from New York after our game here. Hill is in as a receiver. DeAnthony Thomas is in. Ware, 6th consecutive run. Howie Tristan turns his way to the 43 and brought down on the play by Ellis and also by Autry with a gain of 4 out of the 43-yard line.
It's demoralizing to a defense when you can't stop the run. You just look at the Chiefs continue to run the football. 148 rushing yards already in this one. You look at the rushing differential. They have almost 100 yards more on the ground than the Oakland Raiders. And Andy Reid, we talked about, Kevin, one of his strengths, his patience. He will continue to run the football, even if they have a couple of negative runs.
106 on the ground for Ware.
Wouldn't be surprised to see him even run it here.
West is in now with a 3. Demetrius Harris. Hit by Carl Joseph. Gain of 12 on 33. And a Chiefs first down to the 32.
Well, you love when you're able to put a big tight end out there on a smaller safety. Demetrius Harris, a big target for Alex Smith. 6'7", 230 pounds going up against the rookie safety, Carl Joseph, who's only 5'10" tall. That's the matchup you want if you're the Chiefs.
Rams coming down hard. Nine different receivers. Smith is in today. The first and 10 win. Pretty good there. There wasn't a whole lot of room. Losing a yard. Hit by Williams. Let's go to New York with James Brown and Coach Cowan.
Julio Jones' middle name is Elite, Bill. Watch his throw from Matt Ryan to Julio Jones. 36 yards, and the Atlanta Falcons cut the lead. Seattle still leads 17-10.
He's got Tony Gonzalez's respect. Back to Kevin Harlan and Rich Gannon.
He does indeed. The only loss the Falcons have faced this year was in this building, week 2 against Atlanta.
Yeah, they had a great plan coming in. A good job running the football.
Second 12 looking for Harris. Flag is down. It's incomplete. The coverage by Malcolm Smith. Harris was a college basketball player with a look at Pete Morelli. Six officials on this crew have worked a bowl. So it's a terrific crew in the rain here in Oakland this afternoon. Here's former Chiefs linebacker Jack Del Rio, played there in the mid-80s.
Illegal shift. Offense. The penalty will be declined. Third down.
A big third down for the Raiders. This is actually an area, Kevin, coming for today's game where they've actually been pretty good. They've done a nice job getting off the field on third down. Currently, they were second coming in. Opponents were converting just 31% of their third down opportunities today. You look at the Chiefs' success on third down, 5 of 9 so far for Alex Smith.
Longest third down they've had today. Chuck Kendrick West at third and 12. He corkscrews his way in the grasp of defensive end David Amerson. Gain on the play. They get just that much closer. They're still shy of the first down, getting to the 26. And the field goal unit will take the field right now for the Chiefs.
Still be a two-score game here if they convert to be down 16. They score two touchdowns and convert two-point plays. The Raiders have been pretty good in two-point conversion situations this year. They've gone for a bunch of them.
You're right. 3 for 4. You're right, Rich. Well, that 8-yard gain was pretty important because it puts them, instead of a 50-plus yard field goal, to a 44-yard field goal try by Santos. With rain and a bit of wind. Got it. And the Chiefs go up 26-10 with 9:51 to go. Harris caught one for 12. Ware had a run for 8. Ware is over 100 yards on the ground, and the Chiefs are on top. I don't know what's important on that, the 44-yard field goal or the time used, 5.5. Nonetheless, the Raiders held him out of the end zone, and they're going to get the ball back.
And they've got to really pick up the pace here a little bit, Kevin. I always think when you're struggling a little bit to find your rhythm offensively, sometimes it's not a bad idea to go to the no-huddle approach.
Richard to leave it in the end zone. They'll start at the 25. Well, this is where the Raiders have been, and they've usually won when down this year. Timeout.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Voya Financial, changing the way you think of retirement. The Home Depot, more saving, more doing. And by Honda Civic Coupe, be the one they didn't see coming.
Washington out of the backfield, first down and 10 for Derek Carr. On across, Seth Roberts. Out of bounds by Ron Parker with a gain catch, 13 yards. Put him up at the 38-yard line, first down. This team does not blink. They don't panic in close games.
They don't panic, but they have to be concerned right now. You look at the numbers for Derek Carr in the first half as compared to the second half, Kevin. He's been out of rhythm a little bit. He's missed some open receivers.
First and 10. Got another one right here, and that's going to be a gain. Up near the 50-yard line with Nelson and White watching Cooper. It's a gain of 12. It's his first catch in the second half after having 9 in the first half.
I always say in critical situations, you can't think about plays. You have to think about players and who's hot right now. It's obviously Amari Cooper. He already has 10 catches for 129 yards. You have to keep
find ways to feed him the rock.
Tom Bahali is in on the series defensively for the Chiefs. First and 10. Washington big hole, flag down. Sorensen makes the stop in the secondary, down to the Kansas City 42 and a burst of 8. With the flag, as we said, tossed. It's on the Chiefs, too.
Offside, number 91, lined up in the neutral zone. Penalty is declined. Result of the play is a second down.
Well, the struggles that Derek Carr has had, some of it's footwork related. You know, you miss an open receiver like Amari Cooper. This high, you're late with your eyes, and then you get surprised. You don't even feel the linebacker dropping in zone coverage. Difficult second half so far for Derek Carr.
Second down and 2, moving around, and he is very athletic. He has the first down as he dances in front of Poe. He takes it down to about the 36-yard line of Kansas City and a first down run of 6 for Derek Carr.
If I were coaching Derek Carr, Kevin, that'd be the one area of his game that I would encourage him to use his legs
run a little bit more.
He's capable enough of doing it. And you know, it was an opportunity, I think, in the first half to run for a first down. He can do it. Just needs to do it more.
Raiders have had 2 fourth quarter comebacks this year, most notably in New Orleans, and they came to a fourth quarter with 22 points. First and 10 for Derek Carr. And he goes outside. Cooper was defended by White. DJ White, the rookie out of Georgia Tech, knocks it away. Let's go to New York and James and Coach.
No quit in Atlanta.
Number one offense in football, Matt Ryan, Mohamed Sanu, 10 yards, 14 straight points, tied it up 17-17, still in the third quarter.
6:11 remaining in the third, back to Kevin Harlan.
With Roddy White out, they go to the Bengals and get that free agent, Mohamed Sanu.
No lead is safe with that offense right now. Matt Ryan's playing as well as any quarterback in football.
Second 10, they got a nice reception here by the tight end, Michael Rivera. His second reception of the season. He picks up 16. He's to the Kansas City 20-yard line.
Boy, if they could get more production from the tight end position, this offense would almost be unstoppable. You look at the Pro Bowlers they have with Cooper and Crabtree, they just need more production inside at the tight end position.
Peters is hurt. He got dinged. He's left once with dehydration. He's got an interception today, his 5th. And the athletic training staff, Dr. Barnhouse right there in that gray jacket.
Marcus Peters has had a tough game. Kevin went in the locker room earlier for an IV. And
think of the emotion. He's an Oakland native, of course. Went to McClemens High School, Pro Bowler. 13 interceptions since the beginning of last year, the most in the entire league.
You see Derek Carr come back on the field. It's always important to relay the information to the other 10 men in the huddle. This is 4 down territory for the Raiders. They're not going to be kicking field goals here on 4th down. This is 4 down territory. They have 4 shots.
The extra defensive back is the rookie from Minnesota, Eric Murray.
Oh, this is Fossey.
But it kind of shifts around in that secondary. First to 10. Carr. And looking for Crabtree, who they usually do at this end of the field. And they get inside. Coverage on the play, and good it was by Ron Parker, a starter all season.
Not a lot of room here for Carr to fit this one. And even if he catches it, I doubt he'd be able to get both feet in bounds. Crabtree's got to give Carr a little bit more room on the boundary.
Going through the protocols, he's got to stand on the one leg. Second down and 10. Looked like the Karate Kid here. Red zone possession, second and 10. Carr, look out! It's a fumble on the hit by Ford and picked up by Tom Bahali. Ford comes up with a big play. We've talked about the lack of a pass rush. And D. Ford, a first-round pick out of Auburn, comes up with his biggest play of the game. Ali vacuums it in for the Chiefs. Strip sack by Ford. Recovery by the Chiefs. Own 12, first and 10.
You know how to do that.
Ware, over 100 yards, and falling on him right there with the tackle. After a gain of 2 is Bruce Irvin and Stacy McGee, and he's on to about the 13 coming up. After the game time permitting, the Subway postgame show. JB and Company scores, highlights, and news. The Subway postgame show from New York. Well, Justin Houston has been cleared for football-related activities by Dr. James Andrews, and they think maybe in the first week in November, maybe. But they've been counting on four. Today, he answered with a big play.
He did, and getting Justin Houston back. Can you imagine what this will look like? Justin Houston, D4, Tom Bahali.
Second down and eight. Ware and devoured there by Urban. Comes in to make the stop after a gain of five, though, and he's out to the 18-yard line.
What a luxury for Andy Reid. You look at Spencer Ware, Kevin, 111 yards rushing today. You've got Jamal Charles. You're bringing him along slowly and doing the right thing with him. You've got Charcandrick West. We've seen him have big days for the Kansas City Chiefs. You've got a quarterback that's still capable of making a lot of big plays with his legs. In fact, he's probably most dangerous when he extends plays. They are very good and committed to running the football.
Nickel secondary, third and four. Kelsey with a catch. Brought down by Joseph, has a first down on third and four, picks up nine out to the 27-yard line with his first catch today.
Well, this is the matchup they got earlier, Kevin. Kelsey on the rookie. And just look at the size advantage. Travis Kelsey laughing as he goes to the ground.
Yeah, and it's his third catch. I'm wrong on that, excuse me. He had two in the first catch of the second half. And they find him there, first and 10. On the 27. And where? Rene Tardif is up there blocking, and it's a gain of four. And Nico Autry there with a stop.
Yeah, it's been a really productive day for Spencer Ware. He's done the dirty work for the Chiefs inside. He's shown good quickness to get to the edge of the defense with this 45-yard gallop. Catches the ball well out of the backfield. You got to give a lot of credit to the Chiefs running back coach. I think they have one of the best running back coaches in all of football, and Eric Bieniemy, the former University of Colorado Buffalo, and Coach Adrian Peterson. He's coached a lot of good backs.
He went to LSU. He was going to be a quarterback, and then they converted him.
There's
Bieniemy.
There's EB, and he does a terrific job with the backs, and even how they rotate him in and out. It always seems like they have a fresh back on the field.
How do you use these timeouts now, Rich, for both these teams?
Well, at some point, you know, it's not here in this possession, you know, but the Raiders have to start burning those timeouts.
They've got three, Chiefs have two.
And I think they wait, hopefully get off the field here, get a third down, get them in a third down situation and find a way to get off the field and then save them for the next series if they're able to score.
Still no word on Marcus Peters. He's taken off. Looked like concussion protocol. Second and six. Ware again. He spins his way for four out to about the 35-yard line. Couple guys bringing him down. He's got that career-high game going, does Spencer Ware.
One thing you always have to be aware of is there's other ways to stop the clock if you're the Oakland Raiders on offense. You know, any incompletion stops the clock. Runner getting out of bounds, clocking the ball. There's different ways to conserve time. Boy, they've got to find a way to get a stop here on third down.
Third and two.
It's the game right now for the Raiders. If they have any hopes of making this thing interesting late in the game.
Oh, looked like the right tackle, Schwartz, made a move. False start.
False start. Number 71 offense, 5-yard penalty remains, third down.
It's on Schwartz. He has been the best offensive lineman up to today. Rich, that's only the fourth penalty total in the game, two on each side.
Yeah, it's unusual for the Raiders, Kevin. They lead the league right now in penalties, but I really felt like both tackles, Fisher and Schwartz, would have to play well in this one. They in their one-on-one matchups against Mack and Urban, and they've done a nice job. For the most part, they've kept Alex Smith clean, and they really have done a nice job in the running game as well, coming off on the ball and getting movement at the point of attack.
It's third and seven, West. He was hit by McGill, who switched from cornerback to safety last season. We had some shoving across the way. It's between Conley and former Chief, now Raider, Sean Smith, who signed here as a free agent. Oakland has taken a timeout, so they are at two, and the Chiefs have two. Thursday, your weekend starts here when the Chicago Bears take on the Green Bay Packers. Thursday night football on CBS and NFL Network.
And when you're struggling on offense, sometimes a big play in the kicking game, you've got T.J. Carey back there. Of course, the Chiefs have one of the best punters in all of football, and Dustin Colquitt. He's always done a nice job with his hang time, making it very difficult to get a return.
James Winchester with the long snap. Colquitt. Carey. Coming up in the rain with the catch at the 20 and a hand of 4-3-7, and he's brought down by O'Shaughnessy. Zombo, 8-yard return, 46-yard punt. Here comes Carr. He's got a full plate in front of him. If the Chiefs can hold on, this is shaping up as a huge week with Denver's loss earlier on.
Boy, it's a real way to make up some ground on both Oakland and Denver. Kevin, and the Chiefs have been so good coming off their bye under Andy Reid.
It's first and 10. Richard was in the backfield. Flag has been tossed. Crabtree on the cross. DJ White knocks him out of bounds. Gain of 5. Sorensen there too.
Number 72, offense. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Making his 146th consecutive start is the veteran Donald Penn. Left tackle.
I'm going to look at Penn. He's going to overset it, and then Tambahale is just going to beat him right back up inside. Starts him up the field. He comes right back underneath with that swim move inside, and Donald Penn can do nothing but tackle him and bring him to the ground.
Set out practice. Tampa did on Friday. That's just for rest. First and 20 with the penalty. Ooh, what a hit. What a stick. That was Derek Johnson. Loss of a yard, and Richard is down. All-time leading tackler, Rich told you that, leading tackler with this team. Four-time Pro Bowler with the hit on the rookie running back, Richard.
Yeah, just great anticipation right in the middle of your screen. He sees the screen the whole way. He's going to beat the right guard,
and with his
Gabe Jackson, and the back has no chance.
This kid has been a great find for this organization, and their general manager, Reggie McKenzie, getting Jalen Richard, whose first carry in the NFL was a touchdown of 75 yards in the Superdome against the Saints. And he returns kicks, but that time he met a four-time Pro Bowler and got a wake-up call.
Four-time Pro Bowler, that meant business.
Yeah.
You could get that sense last night when we sat down with Derek Johnson.
Yes.
He was very focused. Andy Reid talked about, we asked him specifically, what do you do during the bye week? Why have you had so much success? He says, I let the players get away. I let them relax and get away from football for a while.
Again, Peters is out with the concussion protocol. They go outside here to the tight end. That is Clive Walford with a gain of 5. And he is knocked out of bounds. Sorensen, among others, over there. That was a gain of 5. So it's 3rd and 16.
The turnovers have really been the story in this game, Kevin. Two
yes.
from the Raiders, and Derek Carr has been real good up to this point. He threw the interception, had the fumble, but Kansas City will be 6-1 the last 7 games against Oakland, and the points off the turnovers have been the big story in this series.
16, they need the 39. Derek Carr, Ford is decent. Out of bounds, shy of the 29, picks up 2.
Hey, tell them
Derek Carr.
You know, Bob Sutton, the defensive coordinator for the Chiefs, Kevin, I thought he had a really good plan coming in. You know, the amount of blitzes and pressures are way down, and they've really been relying on their four-man rush. And he's hesitant to bring 5- and 6-man pressures against Carr because he gets the ball out so quickly, and it also exposes you on the back end. Predominantly, have rushed 4 the entire day against Derek Carr.
Within 14, chased again, and there he is again. Flag thrown, D. Ford makes the hit. His second
holding.
Tackle behind
number
the line.
66, offense, penalty will be declined. Result of play, first down.
They were looking for an increased pass rush, Rich, and D. Ford has come up with 2 sacks today, huge.
Well, there's the the penalty inside. Dee Ford's is up the top. He's going to beat Austin Howard around the edge. If it wasn't Howard, it would have been the defensive tackle inside. Look at the effort and the finish from Dee Ford.
He said this week he knows he needs to be more productive. He's been battling some tendonitis in his knee. He's starting for the injured Justin Houston. He has come with a big game today to the Bay Area.
Well, they needed more production from their outside linebackers in terms of the pass rush. Tamahali, just the one sack coming into today's game. Dee Ford had just a sack and a half. I thought both of them were difference makers today against Derek Carr.
Ware out by Emerson, pulled down by Smith, and he picks up seven. Continues to grind out yards. Let's go to New York and James Brown.
Atlanta has 249 yards in the third.
Yeah, 21 straight points. Matt Ryan's third touchdown pass of the day. This one 46 yards to Levine Toilolo. And they now taking the lead 24-17 up in Seattle.
Rich Gannon might have had a quarter like that before. Gosh, back to our guy Kevin Harlan.
What are you laughing about?
No, I'm laughing like an agreement with James. I'm saying, yeah, that's right.
You know it, JB.
Yeah, had a game like that before. He's had several like that.
Back in high school.
Second down and three, Ware. Smith grabs him as he goes into that pile near the 12-yard line. Falcons are one of the big first half of the season stories.
Yeah, the quarterback is playing lights out down there in Atlanta. Matty Ice, great late in games.
2-minute warning. And on CBS begins with 60 Minutes in the vetting of thousands of Syrians seeking refuge status in America, followed by all new episodes of NCIS Los Angeles. Madam Secretary, Elementary, all tonight on CBS on that 3rd and 2. It was a run by Ware. The Chiefs have a season high 185 yards on the ground. And Andy Reid, well, he is amazing what he does after a bye, how he gets a team ready, whether it's in Kansas City or in Philadelphia. That is an incredible mark.
Well, I think they do a great job reevaluating, taking a look at their first four games. They were 2-2. A bunch of self-scout on both sides of the ball. And, you know, he really said, we've got to play better up front. It starts for us up front. If we play well up front, you know, that really sets up everything we want to do in the running game, the passing game. Kevin, they were really good on the early downs. That last third down, it's the sixth time today they were in 3rd and 2 or less.
And today with the win, Rich, Andy Reid will pass Mike Holmgren for number 14 in most wins as a head coach at 175. And he and the Chiefs have now got 7 consecutive AFC Western Division wins. That's amazing that they've won 7 straight within the division.
This is a mature football team with excellent leadership and toughness. And Kevin, I go back to last year when they started 1-5, and they never blinked. They peeled off 10 straight wins to finish the regular season at 11-5 and go on to win a playoff game. I think he's one of the best coaches in all of football.
So the Chiefs have beaten the Raiders for a 4th consecutive time and 6 of the last 7. And with Denver losing to San Diego, look at the Chiefs. They've had their bye, and they are now just that close to the top. And in the division, 2-0. What do they call a road division win? Almost like a win and a half, huh?
Well, it feels that way. You know, it makes the trip back to Kansas City that much more enjoyable. And now that they'll get the Raiders again at some point, Kevin, back in Kansas City.
Yes, and won't that be a good one? Tonight on CBS, 60 Minutes, followed by NCIS Los Angeles, Madam Secretary and Elementary. For Rich Gannon and Scott Kaplan, Kevin Harlan saying so long from Oakland. James Brown comes back after this. You've been watching the NFL on CBS.